psychiatric morbidity among the Rohingya migrants, internationally called FDMN. I welcome you all in this August morning ceremony to my presentation, Psychiatric Morbidity Among the Rohingya Migrants, officially titled FDMN. Rohingya refugee is a geopolitical issue. This issue has incurred an immense socio-economic and cultural burden to Bangladesh. If not solved immediately, this problem will not only break down the economy of Bangladesh, but will also cause permanent cultural changes among the inhabitants on the Bay of Bengal. Not only Bangladesh, almost the whole world got involved in this problem. To manage this 1.2 million refugees, numerous national and international NGOs are working effortlessly. Some are providing food, some are providing shelter, some are looking after sanitation issues, and some are committed to the health issues of this huge population. Among these all, IOM, the International Organization of Migration, no doubt providing and playing the pivotal role. Myself as consultant psychiatrist of IOM since July 2020 got the opportunity to provide psychiatric help to these Rohingya communities and also to the local host population. The Rohingya refugees settled in Cox's Bazar of Bangladesh are in the high risk of mental health issues due to a variety of factors, including prior history of systemic dehumanization, persecution, having witnessed or experienced traumatic events, and daily stressor of remaining in a refugee camp. The history of the Rohingya habitating the Rakhine state of Myanmar includes protracted social and economic exclusion, which ultimately escalated to extreme violence, resulting in a mass exodus of up to an estimated 1.2 million refugees to date. The traumatic events that the Rohingya community suffered, including burning of villages, arrest, sexual assaults, and loss of family and livelihoods. The inhuman military atrocity on an unarmed civil community by the Myanmar military junta created a global holocaust. As such, these inhuman military atrocities attracted a global human response. Many agencies came forward in aid to these human miseries. The major agencies involved in aid to the Rohingya community in Bangladesh are the Bangladesh government itself, especially the Ministry of Health and Family Planning, Ministry of Women and Child Affairs, numerous UN agencies like IOM, UNHCR, UNICEF, international agencies like Terrorist Homes, Danish Refugees, Danish Refugee Councils, SCF, Handicap International, International Rescue Committee, Medicine Sans Frontiers, MSF, Relief International, Save the Children, Working Concern, Red Crescent and Red Crescent Societies, and others. The national NGOs like BRAC, Manoshastra Kendro, Hasina Mission, and others also came forward in aid to this unprecedented human miseries. Many mental health care professionals were also deployed, but the delivery of mental health services continued to be problematic, and hence they had developed a recognized gap in services. Efforts since the beginning of the crisis focused on importing basic psychosocial training and also non-specialized community interventions like psychological first aid. Integrating MHPSs, mental health psychosocial services interventions, and awareness in primary healthcare services also got problematic. The adequate access to basic health services itself has been challenging in the refugee camps due to shortage of supplies, inadequate and inappropriate staff and space, the increase in camp population, during the rapid refugee influx of an estimated 11 lakh refugees hugely exacerbated the challenge. Furthermore, the rescue constraints, poor humanitarian management caused to raise the negative psychological impact by perpetuating anxiety, stress, depression, deterioration, capacity, or resilience. According to a report published by UNHCR, there have been few studies published on mental health concerns of Rohingya refugee populations. Nonetheless, they reported a good number of cases involving explosive anger, expression of medically unexplained psychotic symptoms, impaired occupational performance, suicidal ideation, high level of anxiety, hypervigilance, depression, poor appetite within the refugee community. Factors precipitating such symptoms include not only unwholesome, overpopulated, poor sanitation of the refugee camps, but also the prior traumatic life and protracted stressful experiences persecuted in the Rakhine state prior to their arrival in Bangladesh. The combination of the protracted refugee crisis with the history of stress, persecution, and trauma is a case of concern with the Rohingya, case of concern with the Rohingya refugees. Further investigation into the effects and remedial measures has been recommended. There have been many obstacles with reporting of mental health issues. Substandard understanding of the cultural norms of the refugees. This results in possible misinterpretation of mental health concerns if viewed and diagnosed by the Western standards and definition. So further evaluation and cultural idioms of distress, validation of results, and continued research has been recommended by many national and international agencies. In humanitarian crisis, mental health response typically follow the IASC pyramid of mental health and psychosocial MHPSS services. Ideally, different levels of care are to be provided to the basic services of the communities as well as to the individuals. The philosophy behind this model maintains that individuals of psychological treatment and broad social interventions are the integral part of overall mental well-being and resilience. It also acknowledged that most of the population require minimal psychological interventions in order to improve or prevent adverse mental health outcomes, which can be implemented by mental health workers. However, those who experience impaired functioning due to severe mental distress or who require biological treatment by pharmacological molecules for an existing or developing conditions should be subjected to specialist services by psychiatrists. The Rohingya population happens to be the most persecuted population in the earth. The population comprises both Hindu and Muslim minority group residing in the western state of Rakhine of Myanmar. Formerly, this state was known as Arakan. The religion of this ethnic population happens to be a variation of Sufism. In fact, the Rohingya population is a stateless entity because the Myanmar government does not consider this community as one of the 135 ethnic groups residing legally and culturally in Myanmar. Although the Myanmar government acknowledges Rohingyas, Christians, Sikhs, and Jains as their legitimate citizens, so Rohingya population lacks any legal protection from the Myanmar government. The Myanmar government regards the population as Muslim refugees from Indonesia and Bangladesh. They consider the Hindu Rohingya as the migrated community from Thailand, India, and Laos. So this heterogeneous population got subjected to an inhuman hostility in Myanmar. In the British era between 1837 to 1937, then Burma was a state of India. There were significant movement of laborers from India and Bangladesh to Burma under the British colonization. This migrated population used to be negatively evaluated by the local Burmese population. Following the independence of Burma from British rule, the Myanmar government denied citizenship to this indigenous migrated population. The Rohingya community got exempted from the Union of Citizenship Act in 1982. Following the insurgent movements by the stateless persecuted citizens, the Myanmar government started brutal military crackdown on the Rohingya community, forced them to flee from Myanmar to the neighboring Bangladesh, and thus created the forcibly displaced Myanmar nationals, the FDMNs, the present official nomenclature of Rohingya refugees. In fact, this paper is not a true scientific one. This study is reporting on the basis of my experience about 1 and 3 months period, the number of polyps patients that I attended, the nature of the ailment which I experienced, and the way I managed them. All these I tried to focus in this paper. The patients included were reported to me or was referred to me during this 1 year and 3 months time, with effect from 19/7/2020 to 31/10/2021. I used DSM-4 as a diagnostic tool. The patients included both FDMN, Rohingya refugees, and local population. Mr. Chairman, sir, should I continue for a few slides more, or I should stop it? So should I stop it here? But because I could not give the statistics now still. Okay, the findings. Total number of patients are 1960. Adult patient population 1447, that is 17.47% of the 1960. Child psychiatric patient population 513, that is 26.17%. Adult population includes grand mal epilepsy 554, 38.29%. Schizophrenia 310, 21.42%. Generalized anxiety disorder 17.89%, panic disorder 28.29%, bipolar mood disorder 218, 15.06%, adult autism 56, 3.87%, substance abuse 2.07%. Child psychiatric patients, total number 513, that is 30.35% of the total population, patient population. Grand mal epilepsy was 171, 33.35%, autistic spectrum disorder 269, 52.43%, attention deficit hyperactive disorder 29.23%, childhood aneurysm 13.53%, conduct disorder 0.5.97%, childhood depression 5.97%. From the very beginning of enrollment to IIM, I had the desire. The whole world is looking at the Rohingyas, the most persecuted and stateless community in the earth. They have fled from adjacent country Myanmar to Bangladesh because of unprecedented atrocities by the Myanmar security forces. This community is under all forms of stress since the dawn of independence of Myanmar. Because of this inhuman age-old oppression, the community developed different types of neurological functional disorder. For the sake of humanity and expression of an expansion of knowledge, I think it is the responsibility of Bangladesh psychiatric community to carry a detailed mass study on Rohingya refugees and also on the local population. I thank you all for the patient hearing of this non-scientific article. I express my utmost gratitude to all concerned for giving me this platform to inform you a report about which the whole world is eager to know. Thank you very much.